Hello everyone, just a quick one today, because a lot of people have been asking me the same question recently, and it obviously bothers a lot of people, so we need to get this sorted out. Why does 0.999 recurring equal 1? Now, I completely understand why people ask this question. I remember asking my maths teacher this myself when I was at school, and there's one thing I wish I'd been told early on. It would have sorted out a lot of problems, and that is, when we write numbers decimally, sometimes we have more than one way to write the same number. So 0.999 recurring is just another way to write the number 1. In the same way, 0.24999 recurring is just another way to write 0.25. It's just notation, and our notation isn't unique. So sometimes there's a long version to write a number, and sometimes there's a short version to write the number. And obviously we pick the short version. You can show this. There's a quick way to do it if you want. You could say s equals 0.999 recurring, and then say, oh, times it by 10. 10s equals 9.999 recurring. Take the difference, and you'll get 9s equals to 9, and obviously then s equals 1. So you've got s equals 0.999 recurring and s equals to 1. Now that isn't a mistake. What we've shown here is that there are two ways to write down the same number. You can do it another way. Look at the difference. So let's take 1 minus 0.999 recurring. Then you could think of it as a string of zeros, 0.0000, going on forever. And it does go on forever. There is no number at the end of that. There is no pot of gold at the end of that rainbow. It just goes on forever, 0.0000. In other words, it's zero. Technically, we say it's infinitesimally small, but that's zero for us. That doesn't mean it's close to zero, it means zero. And that's really all I have to say about that.